The Premier League season ends today, and Gareth Southgate is set to announce his 23-man squad, or 30-man squad, and then cut down to 23 on, I think he's planning to announce it on Wednesday, so that's not too long. So I thought I'd do my squad and see just how it compares to when he announces it. I am in the logo today. I thought that was interesting. Hope you like it. And let me know your thoughts down below on that. So, 23 men I have chosen. In goals, three goalkeepers go. Nick Pope from Burnley. Bit of an obvious one. He's done really well. Well, he's done fantastic since replacing Tom Heaton. Serves to go. Second of all, Jack Butland from Stoke. Another obvious pick. Third, Jordan Pickford from Everton, who I think that Gareth Southgate will have in goal when it comes to the first game against Tunisia. So, in defence, I've gone with Kyle Walker, who can play both, as he did against the Netherlands. Kieran Trippier. Trent Alexander-Arnold. Ryan Bertrand. Ashley Young. James Tarkowski. Harry Maguire and John Stones. Into midfield. Eric Dier of Tottenham. I've gone with Fabian Delph. I think that he deserves to go. He's had a great season. He's won a lot of games. That's always helpful. He can fill in at left back if Gareth wants him to. I think he'd be great. Jordan Henderson. He's basically captain, isn't he? So he's got to go. Probably our best central midfielder. He's at Liverpool. Jack Wilshere. He's had an okay season. We've not really got that many options. Jesse Lingard, Manchester United. He's had a fantastic season. He's one of the first names onto the plane. Dele Alli. He can provide magic at any point. So you need him there. Controversially, a little bit, Jonjo Shelvey. I love Jonjo. I think he's great. I can understand why Gareth is not keen on picking him, because he is a live wire. He is likely to either create something special and have a great tournament, or the total opposite and get sent off in the first game and never see him again. But I have included him just in case he does do something special, which he's likely to do. Okay, so we've got five strikers or wingers as well. Sterling, who's had a fantastic season. You've got to get him in there. Marcus Rashford. We haven't got really that many options around that sort of area. I don't want to take Lallana. He hasn't played enough football. He can also fill in a striker if we were desperate. 21 is Harry Kane, probably the number one pick at this point. He's the only player really who could, you know, get a good amount of goals to help England through the knockouts. 22, Jamie Vardy. He offers a lot of pace. He offers a lot going forward. He'll definitely be on the bench, don't get me wrong, but he'd be a great addition to bring on to the pitch if we needed him. And 23, another striker, I've gone with Danny Welbeck, who has had a decent end of the season. He's got a few goals in the Europa League, so hopefully that means he will do okay in Russia. It's hard. I wouldn't want to be Gareth Southgate in this situation, because, you know, there's a lot of people I've missed out here. Gary Cahill has had a really poor season. Jamal Lascelles, I can't see him being picked. Will he pick such, like, a few of the younger lads? I did put Lewis Cook in there and I took him out. He may well go. Could he take Andy Carroll of West Ham for a little bit of more of a physical presence? I don't know. I don't know what his plans are. But that's my team. Let me know who you would have picked, if there's anyone you disagree with, or anyone you think definitely should be going onto the plane and going to Russia for the World Cup. Let me know your thoughts down below. But that is my squad, so I'll read it one more time. Nick Pope, Jack Butland, Jordan Pickford, Kyle Walker, Kieran Trippier, Trent Alexander-Arnold, Ryan Bertrand, Ashley Young, James Tarkowski, Harry Maguire, John Stones, Eric Dyer, Fabian Delph, Jordan Henderson, Jack Wilshere, Jesse Lingard, Jonjo Shelvey, Dele Alli, Raheem Sterling, Marcus Rashford, Harry Kane, Jamie Vardy, and of course, Danny Welbeck. That's my 23. I don't have much hope for this tournament. I really don't. I'm happy just getting out of the group and losing to... Besides, it does okay in the tournament. So if we lost and, I don't know, got knocked out by Spain, I'll be okay with that, because I'm really not expecting much. So anything other than that is decent. How far do you think we'll go? I'm really interested to hear what your thoughts are on that. Let me know your thoughts on the layout. I might change it before the start of the World Cup. So let me know your thoughts down below. Subscribe if you're new. I am Mike, and I will see you soon. Thank you for watching.